Coming after the JM, and we have eliminated 18 terrorists so far in the last 21 days. Out of them, 14 being from JM, and 6 of them their main commanders. And we have also eliminated JM's second commander, Mudassir, who was active for more than a year now and was the main conspirator in the National Highway convoy attack on the CRPF convoy. Kamran, like I told you last time, was eliminated on 17th and 18th. And today we have eliminated Mudassir of Mandura village, Tral, a local terrorist. Along with him, the search is still going on, and the ascertaining the bodies and the identity of the other terrorists is still going on. However, the initial input suggests there was also a terrorist who has been eliminated by a codename Khalid of Pakistan, JM. As I was telling you, out of the 18 terrorists killed so far, 8 are Pakistanis and 10 are the local terrorists, including 2 of Haliti and 2 of Hizbul Mujahideen. And again, I would like to reinforce here, our main emphasis after the 14th of February convoy attack was elimination of the JEM leadership, and we have been very successful in doing that in about 3 weeks' time ever since that time. The terrorist killed in yesterday's operation in Pinglish, it was on a specific intelligence of sources wherein we cordoned this house, and in an operation which lasted overnight and the day, this terrorist was eliminated. There was not a scratch on 2 armed forces. We'll continue till we eliminate all of them. I would now like to request IGP Kashmir and IGP CRPF to give their initial comments. Thereafterwards, we will be open to questions.
In which Mudassir Ahmad Khan got eliminated was definitely a very significant operation. It is doubly significant for the CRPF because Mudassir was involved in the 31st December 2017 Lathpura camp attack, as well as the attack on our convoy on the 14th of February. I congratulate all the security forces involved in this operation. It was a very clean operation. And but our job is still not done. Very important players in the dramatis personae still remain. The people who motivated and radicalized Mudassir Khan, the people and the criminals who supplied him with explosives and other means to effect these attacks would be dealt with. We are working in close coordination with the National Investigative Agency, the NIA, and I'm sure sooner than later, the rest of these players who are involved in this attack on a convoy shall be dealt with. That's all. And lastly, I would like to also comment that following the 14th February attack on our convoy, there was a lot of support from people from all over the country, including Kashmir. The CRPF is deeply indebted and we acknowledge it very humbly. Thank you.
The modus operandi they adopted was basically trying to recruit youngsters in the belt, and Mudassir was wanted for that. Initial input on Mudassir started surfacing a year ago, then subsequently he joined Jaish-e-Mohammed. And today the elimination of this group, particularly in last fortnight, the kind of operation that those things have taken place against Jaish-e-Mohammed, a significant dent has been caused to the outfit. Also, I would also highlight the recruitment part. The recruitment part in last 3 months have significantly come down, which all statistics show. And regarding this module, their motivation and the way they were operating, they were trying to recruit people, we are investigating. There are different cases which are registered. I did not go into the details of the crime profile of these people, but at the outset I can say there are serious investigations which are going against these outfits. Also, the National Investigation Agency is doing the investigation of this particular case. So the material and other details which we have obtained from this case shall be shared with the National Investigation Agency for in pursuance of their investigation of the case. Regarding the encounter site, as it was mentioned, the search is still underway. There are materials which we are trying to collect, and as soon as the search is over and the identity, two identities which have come, one Mudassir is confirmed, the other identity which we have received is Code Khalid, who is a Pakistani terrorist apparently.
Mark my words very carefully. Local recruitment in the last few months has seen a downward decline. But point about the suicide bombers or any other type of modus operandi which the terrorist might take or utilize or use, we are aware and we are keeping a track of all such modus operandi which the terrorists can use, and we are taking corrective measures about it. Here I would like to tell you one thing. One incident which happens, which comes to the light and which comes to the media, 99 incidents are averted. For every one incident which happens, 99 incidents are averted because of the security forces, because of the intelligence agencies, and because of the complete security forces team, which works day in and day out. So any type of modus operandi which the terrorists might like to use in future, we are prepared for it. We are taking corrective measures for it.